Hello everyone. So today I want to talk about living in a motorhome in New Zealand. Some people asked me to do some reviews, so I just show you a little bit from my motorhome. So basically what a motorhome is, it's a vehicle that's self-contained. It has kitchen, has its own water, has shower, a sleeping area, so in my van 5 people can sleep, and toilet of course, and I can live in it. And the best thing about that you are mobile, you can live anywhere you want, and New Zealand is a really good place for doing that. The thinking behind why I moved living in that, not because I can't rent or buy a house, because of my highest value is freedom. And if I doing things in my life that gives me the most freedom, so I will do that. And taking a mortgage, let's say if I want to live in Auckland, wasn't really a good idea. And even though it will take me 10 or 15 years or maybe less, I don't want to do it. I don't want to be thinking about how to pay the mortgage, how to pay the bills. I lived that lifestyle just when I came to New Zealand. I lived that lifestyle when I was a student in Israel and here. I didn't like it. I didn't have free time, but I love having free time. I love, waking up in beautiful places like that. And change these places if I want to, and be self-sufficient as possible, especially in the world today with all this lockdown and madness that's going on. So there's something for me, like this is, it's basically about lifestyles, and I tried lots of lifestyles. Let's say when a few years ago, when I was living in the city in Auckland, and I was working 8 till 5, and after 5 or 6 you come home or whatever, and you have just maybe 2 or 3 hours to do anything for yourself, and then you basically need to prepare for work again. So it doesn't matter if you love your job or not, but still, sometimes you don't want to work for months, you just want to enjoy life, enjoy nature, you want to meet people, or whatever what you want to do. And you know, life is very, very short. And for me also, because I'm a really health fanatic, I'm a plant-based eater, and I eat mostly organic, mostly fruits, and I love the sun. And I live in very, very healthy lifestyle because I'm investing in my body. And then when I'm investing in my body, I'm feeling good. And that's the point. We all want to feel good. Most of our actions that we are doing is because we want to feel good. And therefore, I'm doing that. So I'm located in one of the campgrounds. So I'll talk a little bit about how it works in New Zealand. So probably you're asking me, how do I get water and power and all the other things. So in my motorhome I have solar panels, and as you can see, now it's winter in New Zealand, in the South Island, in the coldest place in New Zealand. And around me there are mountains with snow everywhere, and last night it was like -3, so it was cold. But I felt warm, but I was quite warm inside, and I must say, living in this motorhome, it was a lot more warm than in most of the houses I lived in New Zealand during the years. So I see basically just advantages. So the power that I have, if I have like days with less sun, so it's still light, so still I have battery that charged by the solar panels, and for me it's enough. And that's in case like I'll be in my motorhome all day off grid, like out in nature, like without anyone. So I'll need to think about it. But at the moment, like in a place like this, like you can plenty of solar power for free, and forget about paying bills. And you can work basically from everywhere. If doing like a business like me, or doing something else online, and basically today online it's very popular way to work, and a lot of people moving online because of the situation today. Like, where do I get the water from? So around New Zealand you have a lot of water tubes, like in gas stations or like dump stations around. You can fill a water tank that I have. The water tank usually lasts for me between 3-4 days till 1 week, and also like the grey water. And you just have station that you empty those and fill fresh water, and that's it. Same the toilet. Toilet has like a cassette toilet. You can have like use maybe a week, and then I can empty it, and that's it. It's very very simple. And all around New Zealand you have these stations. All around New Zealand, so it's very very convenient. Now, next thing, where do I park? So there are, each council, each area has some areas where you can allow to park when you're not allowed to park. Basically you're allowed to park everywhere, except there is a bylaw of the specific council that says okay, you can't park over there. But in most places you can park, especially now when you kind of not really, when there is not a lot of tourists, especially today. But yeah, you can park just mostly everywhere except the places that you're not allowed. And of course you have to have self-contained certificate. It means that you have your own water and toilet and whatever, and it won't contaminate the place. So this is basically it. And before I actually start living like that, I didn't know how it's going to be. That's why I tried. If you not try, how can we know? So that's how. Say hi. Yeah, anyway, so if not try, how can we know? So that's basically it. So more advantages living like that. I can assure you will save lots of money, even though there is maintenance, especially if your motorhome is not new. And but it's a lot less than even a house, and a lot less issues. And it allows you to be mobile. And for me, it allows me to save money and travel the world. So I don't mind, you know, sometimes stop for full-time work in different places for some amount of time, but if I know it's going to be endless, like this is going to be like a lifestyle of 8 till 4, oh, no way. Some people kind of like it, some people not really. So I prefer doing that. And also you meet so many people around, and very interesting people, and you socialize, and it kind of gives you a sense of community, a sense of connection. And this is something that was quite hard as when you as an immigrant, especially myself, coming here alone without family, without a partner, whatever. For me it was really a challenge, because to find this belonging community. It's very, very important. A lot of people actually not immigrating because they afraid to leave their friends and loved ones and kind of start fresh in a new, very far away country. It takes courage, but believe me, it's worth it. You will be a lot stronger person and learn a lot about yourself while doing that. And you can say like a lot of people are doing that. So I'm already doing that for almost 2 months. Almost 2 months doing that, and that allowed me to do my mission to explore a lot of areas in New Zealand. And quite happy about it. Another challenge for me, like I'm don't really good in maintenance. I have my skills that are quite good in mental health, but that's what I do in New Zealand mostly. And I have my experience and knowledge about immigration to different countries, especially to New Zealand. But in maintenance, I'm not really good. What can I say? But that's what allows me now opportunity to learn. And of course, it's not easy. But it's interesting, challenging, rewarding. So. And another thing, like you're waking up in such amazing places all the time. Like such amazing places and peaceful places, like far away from cities and towns and traffic and you have quiet. And you can really think what you want in life and with no rush. And to think about who you are hanging out with and do some kind of review on what's next. It's really, really nice. So this kind of lifestyle allows me to critically think and evaluate what's happening around the world and also with my life. Yeah. And this is something that unfortunately a lot of people don't have, because a lot of people invest a lot of their energy into seeing the news or counting how many COVID cases in their country and what the government will announce next. Of course, that's something that you need to be aware of the regulation and the laws on what's happening, but not something that you need to do every day and just, oh, how many cases, or should I wear a mask or not. It's essential to have a fresh air to breathe. You put a mask, it's you're basically breathing your, no, the air that goes outside, that's not really clean. So you see how people come and relax here. Really, really nice. So that's another experience. I don't know how long I'm going to live like that, but for now it's a lot better than renting, flatting, taking a mortgage. I never took a mortgage. And it gives you freedom. So, unfortunately, some people in New Zealand don't like people who doing freedom camping. And the reason is, like a lot of people, freedom camping kind of contaminate and throw garbage and rubbish around and afterwards. Yeah, that makes sense. I can understand these people, but for example, people like myself, most people are very careful about the environment. They are cleaning after themselves. And I'm even cleaning rubbish after other people. That's not really fair. And other reasons that I heard, that people saying that, oh, why I pay rates and all these bills and that, while you kind of having to live for free, what the hell? So they're kind of jealous, and that's kind of not nice to hear, but some people like that as well exist. Yeah, so that's a little bit about me and what I'm doing. So if you have any questions about motorhome living in New Zealand, feel free to ask and I'll tell you more about it.